Imagine that every time your family was going to go somewhere, you all got in the car, you put the car in neutral, and you all pushed. You pushed the car to the store, you pushed the car to school, you pushed the car to church. In theory, could this be done? In theory, could be done. Would take you forever to get anywhere, right? And you'd be exhausted constantly. Well, most Christian families today are like that family. I call them Flintstone families. Because here's what they do. They bring two things to the table to deal with all the problems and all the stress, all the marriage problems, all the kid problems, the financial problems, you name it. They bring two things to the table. They bring good intentions. Most Christian families I know mean well. Most of them that I know, the mom means well, the dad mean well, the kid mean well. And the second thing they bring to the table is willpower. They're trying. They really are. Most Christian families I know are trying. Be a good dad, be a good mom, be good kids, etc. Have you ever had a big family fight and you finally get around the kitchen table to work it all out and finally this person says they're sorry, this person says it's okay, this person says sorry, this person says it's okay. And you then finish with your grand speech. And the grand speech is something along the lines of, okay, everybody, we all just need to try so that this doesn't happen. How many have you ever done that? Okay. So what just happened? The sinfulness of your hearts just came out in your home, right? Could have affected everybody, could have just been with two of you or whatever. And now all the shrapnel, you picked up all the pieces, you're trying to work on all of it. And how are we going to change that? How are we going to grow? Well, we're going to mean well. We have to mean well, and we are going to try harder. Folks, if that's the way your family works, you are the Flintstone family. You are pushing your family in neutral everywhere you go. It's going to take you forever to get anywhere. And you're going to be exhausted all the time. When in fact, God's given your family a supernatural engine. And that engine are these few minutes of family worship in your home. That engine are these few supernatural moments of family prayer, family Bible reading. And this is why Satan and the demons are going to make it top priority to make sure you do not turn on that engine.